A young man came to me today. He said, "Hey, Fred, I want to leave a legacy so that my children's children's children can remember me." This is what I told him. I said, "You see, if nobody believes in you, you must believe in yourself. And best in you is the enabler of self." Well, I know Fred Hodges is in the class all by himself. Greatness is a lot of small things put together, so make sure those little things is going to make you better. You see, for me, I'm on a mission every day, and I have him above to remind me that everything is okay. I have developed my passion in this game called life. People have been for me, people have been against me. I have withstanding at times it was those I thought were friends the ones holding the knife. I have created my story, sometimes charged my name. However, I did not allow that to destroy me. I've been depressed, I've been oppressed, I've been shattered, broken, and mentally beaten. However, my journey defined me, and I did not allow that to defeat me. I told the young man, that's it. Be the narrator of this story. Live life every day as if you dream for the world to know your glory. Keep this in mind. Adversity defines identity. Don't quit because it's up to you to turn your test into a testimony. Every day creates a new opportunity to soar, but if opportunity does not knock, it's up to you to build that door. Embrace faith. If it doesn't come right away, it will come on the right day. Know that fear kills dreams. Fear kills hope. Do not allow negative emotions to stop you from climbing that rope. That rope towards your dreams, towards your goals, towards your accomplishments. Do not allow your name to be placed on the list of the weak and incompetent. Find your passion, create your mission, live life with that tunnel vision. Because I promise you, at the end, you'll hit gold. Success isn't handed out like a box of tissue. And all you have is a common goal. The young man looked at me feeling inspired. He said, "Today is a new day because I have a new fire." He said, "I thank you. I feel less stressed because I wake up every day with a step closer towards success." Yes. And as some of y'all would say, yeah. How's everybody doing?
Good.
How's everybody doing?
Good.
Yeah, that's all I can hear. Come on, let's get it. For those who do not know me, my name is Fred Hodges. I have a master's degree here at Edinboro University of Pennsylvania in college counseling, which I've also done my undergrad here at Edinboro University of Pennsylvania in communications. I have a master's degree in communications. I am now currently the Assistant Director for Educational Equity and Diversity Programs at Penn State Barron. So can I get a yeah? There's a couple things that I want to say. First off, I want to applaud each and every last one of you who's getting an award. That is a great accomplishment. So for those that are receiving the ALANI Awards, I want to applaud you today. I mean, because coming from somebody like me, it's not easy. And believe me, I have a story. It wasn't easy. So I applaud the faculty and staff members who helped those individuals receive an award today. And most importantly, I want to applaud the family members and the friends of those who receive an award today. As I said, as I always say, you know, show me your five best friends, I'll show you your future. With that being said, you gotta always surround yourself around people who want to be successful just as you. You gotta always surround yourself around people who want to see you successful. And you wanna surround yourself around those people who will push you, not someone who will hurt you. So for those that are here, those family members and those guests who push our award recipients today, I applaud you. Look, I see you, Mom. Hey. I have a couple of things that I want to say, and it won't be long, because my hands up there like hurrying socks. The first thing is, during your journey here at Edinboro University, please keep this in mind. Do not get comfortable where you are. Do not get comfortable where you are, because the moment that you're feeling comfortable, the moment you're holding yourself back from something great. I'll tell you that right here, right now, never get comfortable. Because there are things about yourself, there are goals, and there are ambitions about yourself that you'll find out within yourself once you get out of your comfort zone. So by body is going to react to that. Everything starts here. Everything starts here. So please keep that in mind. Create goals. And then create goals to accomplish your goals. And then once you accomplish your goals, create more goals. They say that the wealthiest place in the world is where? Who knows? The graveyard. They say the wealthiest place in the world is the graveyard. You know why? Because I see some people looking at me like, no, it ain't. I'm trapping. It is, actually. Because there are so many goals unaccomplished. There are so many dreams that are not lived out yet. There are so many people that had these ideas that they didn't get a chance to experience. Why? Maybe because they got comfortable. Maybe because the world got too hard for them. Maybe they gave up. So don't quit. But there's a couple things I just want to remind you for that. Granted, yes, I love the Pittsburgh Steelers. I love them to death. But one of my favorite people to watch is Ray Lewis. Because he says, greatness is a lot of small things put together. So you need to train for a lifestyle. Just like athletes do. Every single day, they train. They do little things to perfect their art, to perfect their craft. So I'm telling you, you can do that. But instead of applying it to sports, apply it to the classroom. And not just the classroom, but apply it to your goals. Apply it to your dreams. Apply it to those things that you have in mind. I'm pretty sure almost everybody in this room dreams to be successful. But, as I said in the poem, success isn't handed out like a box of tissue when all you have is a common cold. I got a cold. I wish success was handed out like a box of tissue. There's an old African proverb that says, if there's no enemy within, the enemy outside can do no harm. So that's another thing I want to keep you guys in mind. Or that's another thing I want to remind you guys. Is you are your biggest enemy. So that moment when you said this is too much, my studies is too much, you know what, I'm going to take a seat. That's when you're going to be active. I commend every last one of you here that got a gold star, that got a gold, that got a bronze, that got a silver award. But for those who got a bronze, try next semester to get a silver. For those who got a silver, try next semester to get a gold. For those who got gold, try next semester to get a gold star. And for those who got a gold star, try next semester to create your own. And the last thing I want to leave you with is, this is my most favorite thing to say, my students. You're like, come on, Fred. Every time you speak, you gotta say this. But it's so encouraging because I'm telling you, hey, it's not an easy road. I'm speaking from experience. It's not an easy road. And for those who know me, know I've been up and down. I've been on both sides of the track. But this is one thing that I always keep in mind, and this is one thing that I always want to pass to other individuals. I turn my test into a testimony, and here's my testimony, so I want y'all to repeat after me. I was born at the right time. I was born in the right place. I was born in the right race. I was born in the right family. And I'm not a mistake. Let's say it again. Let's say it like you mean it. But don't just say it. Feel it. I was born in the right time. I was born in the right place. I was born in the right race. I was born in the right family. And I'm not a mistake. One last time, for good sake, I say it and scream it. I was born in the right time. Thank you, everyone. I love you all.